Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. So we are continuing our FPD sessions. Topic for today is finish lines in FPD. In last session, I was talking about the principles of tooth preparation. In that, we had marginal integrity. So this comes under marginal integrity. So this is a small topic, but it should be included in the marginal integrity. Since it is a little confusing, I am taking it as a separate topic. So finish line is nothing but the axial wall meets the gingival wall, where the final part or the gingival part of the retainer will be placed. So it has got importance in aesthetics and preservation of tooth structure. So a finish line should be following a few characteristics. That is, shallow bevels which are parallel to the cavo surface should be avoided, because the restoration will be too thin at this area and may chip easily. So that is, the discrepancy decreases with the increasing in angulation of the bevel. And few points to be noted while doing the finish line. One thing is, the bevel should not produce a very acute margin, which can lead to fracture of the wax pattern during removal. You can see here, should not create any acute margins. So the shallow cava surface bevels may lead to chipping of the restoration, and also the tooth should not be reduced more than half of the width of the diamond burr, because over reduction may lead to the formation of a lip of unsupported enamel, which is known as lipping. So we should not create lipping or chipping while doing our final preparation. Now let's start with a few finish line designs. The first one is chamfer, then we have shoulder, knife edged, feather edge, then we have modification, radial shoulder, heavy chamfer. So all these differs in angulation, okay, angulation of the axial wall to the gingival wall. So chamfer is nothing but finish line possesses a curved slope from the axial wall till the margin. This is the axial wall till the margin. There is a curved slope. So this is the axial wall, this black one, and this is the gingival wall. So there is a curved slope. This is a slope, okay, just like this. Whereas a shoulder, there is an acute angle. Sorry, there is a 90 degree angle, not acute angle, 90 degree angle between the axial wall and the gingival wall. So that is the difference between chamfer and shoulder. Whereas a knife edge, there is no such angulation. Okay, it is almost straight line. So in chamfer, it can be produced using a torpedo diamond point, and this is commonly used in cast metal crowns or metal only portion of PFM crowns. This is very distinct. It can be easily identified. It has got very least stress. So only half of the diamond tip will be placed, not completely, just half of the diamond. The burr which we use for marginal preparation, just half we keep at the margin. So that is about the chamfer. So it has got least stress and good success rate. Whereas a heavy chamfer, what it does is it changes the angulation. This is a small one. So heavy chamfer, the cava surface margin will be large. Okay. So it will produce a 90 degree cava surface angle with a large round radius. So that was about chamfer and heavy chamfer, where the heavy chamfer is indicated for all ceramic crowns. Okay, all ceramic crowns. This was indicated in cast metal restoration. This is for all ceramic crown, which has got better than conventional chamfer properties. Bevel is added. If we want, a bevel can be added to use for metal restoration. Bevel is nothing but at the end, we just keep a bevel. Okay, we are placing a bevel here. It is just like this. Now we have the shoulder. So shoulder is having a 90 degree angulation, which is for again all ceramic crown, and it has got good resistance to occlusal force, because this part is good enough to withstand the occlusal forces, and there is no chipping, and it minimizes the stress which leads to fracture of porcelain. So there is least stress here. We use flat end tapered burr, not so this flat end of tapered burr we use, and this is healthy contour and it improves aesthetics. It has got good aesthetics. So there is 90 degree sharp internal line angle. So this is the internal line angle, sharp 90 degree internal line angle. But it cannot be used for cast metal restoration because there will be concentration of stress on tooth. So there will be 90 degree angle. So this is not suitable for cast metal restoration because there is stress and chances of coronal fracture because the stress is concentrating on the tooth. Next we have the sloped shoulder. Okay, the modification of shoulder, this 90 degree will become 120 degree. Okay, this is 120 degree, nothing much changes, just the angulation changes and it becomes 120 degree. So facial margins of a metal ceramic crown can be used with a sloped shoulder. There is no unsupported enamel, so we have sufficient bulk to allow thinning of the metal framework to a knife edged or acceptable aesthetics. The radial shoulder is different one. It is a modified type of shoulder with cava surface angle 90 degree and which is having a shoulder with lessened with rounded internal angles. Next is a shoulder with a bevel. Okay, shoulder with a bevel. So shoulder with a bevel is nothing but with a 90 degree cava surface angle with a bevel. Okay, so this is how it is. This is 90 degree cava surface angle with a bevel. So that is shoulder with bevel. It is indicated in proximal box for inlays and onlays or occlusal shoulder of onlays and mandibular 3/4 crown and facial finish line of metal ceramic restoration where the gingival aesthetics is not very critical and situations where a shoulder is already present. So all these areas we can just provide a bevel. So it is not like a sloping shoulder, that is 120 degree. Okay, this is like 90 degree with a bevel. Okay, so don't get confused. This is sloping shoulder where we have 120 degree. This is shoulder with a bevel. Okay, after having this 90 degree, we put a bevel. Knife edge which permits acute margin of metal. There is no much angulation between the axial wall and gingival wall. And this thin margin, which is maybe difficult for waxing and casting. And this is also susceptible for distortion, but which is indicated in mandibular posterior teeth with very convex axial surface and lingually tilted lower molars. So next we have one more thing, that is a feather edge, which is also known as shoulderless preparation. Okay, so this is similar to knife edge preparation, but is marginally very thinner. It has the same disadvantages as knife edge preparation. So chisel edge preparations are similar to feather edge margin, but it is marginally thicker. That was chisel edge. Okay, chisel edge is similar to the feather edge, but it is marginally thicker. Okay, so that was about our preparations, various finish lines. So we learned basically the very common chamfer and shoulder. Only thing is the angulation. This is almost like, so shoulder we have radial shoulder, sloping shoulder with a bevel, chamfer we have heavy chamfer, then we have the knife edged, feather edge, which is also another shoulderless, also chisel edge. So that was all about the finish lines in FPD. So I'll come up with a new topic in prosthodontics. Thank you.